Hey guys, Maurice here from Carnivore Done Right, and today's topic is very, very important for a lot of ketogenic and strict carnivore dieters out there. It's gonna be in regards to electrolytes. So when it comes down to electrolytes, now too few electrolytes will cause the body to cramp and many other symptoms will start to kind of appear. Now electrolytes require more work than either caloric or hydration needs. You will need to actually experiment quite a bit based on your athletic performance, geared towards proper refueling under various conditions. So electrolytes are required to make everything running smoothly, proper functioning of digestive, nervous, cardiac, and muscular system. Now, muscle cramping, as it happens, your body is giving you a very painful signal to refuel, as your body is far down the road of electrolyte depletion. Now the body is asking for help, and if you do not respond immediately to the situation, far more damage could actually happen, specifically to the heart. And keep in mind, the heart is a muscle as well too. So what are electrolytes and why do we need them? Now electrolytes are chemicals that form electrically charged particles in body fluids, right? The ions carry this electric energy to perform many functions, including muscle contractions and transmissions of nerve impulses. So many athletics and audience practicing ketogenic, strict carnivore diet are constantly required to supplement electrolytes. Do not wait until you get a painful cramping. You will actually notice by your performance. As advocate, electrolytes will keep you performing at such a high level, and the moment you start to actually feeling a bit weakness, not able to sleep properly, not able to recover properly from a training session, that means there could be a slight deficiency in your electrolytes. So make sure you keep that level at its peak. Also, one of the major symptoms that it could be major for some audience and it could be something minor for some, but you know, if you do have an existing condition, then this is something you definitely have to worry about and look into it furthermore. It's getting a regular heartbeat. So definitely having adequate enough electrolytes in your body is essential. So one question I tend to get lots from my Instagram audience claiming that Himalayan salt should do the job. Well, two reasons it's not acceptable. One, yes, they provide only two of the electrolytes your body requires, sodium and chloride, as the other minerals are way too low. Second, you might end up oversupplying with so much sodium, therefore overwhelming the body's complex mechanism for regulating sodium, right? Guess what happens? High sodium intake will actually throw off your potassium levels. Therefore, more potassium would be required. That's why you have many influencers, they tend to recommend an intake of 4,000 milligrams or more of potassium per day. Now, that said, it would definitely benefit anyone who is on a SAD diet. But when it comes down to carnivore and or ketogenic zero carb eating, your body will require way less potassium as long as you don't actually conflict and play with your sodium and chloride intake coming from Himalayan salt. That's why I do not recommend supplementing with potassium at all, because even if you are potassium deficient and you play with your potassium levels, you can actually throw the full electrolyte family out of balance, and that will end up causing major deficiency. And one of the most important ones you start to feel is in your digestive. So sodium requirements for an average individual is roughly about 500 milligrams on a daily basis. And for athletic performance, you're looking up to 2000 milligrams daily. And this is supplied from natural unprocessed foods. Based, of course, in your caloric intake. So let's talk about electrolyte formula, focusing on a zero carb diet such as carnivore diet and or strict ketogenic. Best way to replenish electrolytes. From what we've seen, some audience tend to consume a couple of pounds of meat on a daily basis, which an average person, it does tend to get quite expensive. So if you are like me and or others who tend to stick to specific amount of protein to fat ratios. You know, for fat, we do not consume such a large amount of meat. And what we tend to do is, yes, we tend to consume nose to tail for beef, from organs, fish roe, oysters, etc. But sometimes this is not accessible all year long. Then an electrolyte formula should be consumed to continue having a proper fluid balance. So two things I would recommend. One is drinking spring clean water as much as possible. Two is having a pre-made formula, as I was mentioning earlier. And you will notice most of these formulas are super low in the amount of milligrams for the electrolytes, that you do not need to take as much as some of the influencers mentioned or doctors, because this is properly made to keep the body fluids balancing properly without causing any major issue. Because having such a high amount of whether it's magnesium, potassium, sodium will throw the other minerals, the other electrolyte minerals out of balance, and that will create even more issues, more symptoms. So having a proper form that is actually made well, that would be my first choice. So here are the proper electrolytes that you should look for. I cannot say how much each one of you should consume daily. What works for me might be too little or too much for you based on your daily activity, right? So now each formula created by different companies have some added vitamins and or amino acids, but the most important electrolytes that you should be looking for are as follow. You got one is your calcium, two potassium, three magnesium, four is your sodium, and number five is your chloride. So getting your fluid and caloric needs dialed in and nailed down is fairly easy to accomplish. But fulfilling your electrolyte needs does require more attention because you have most variability to account for. Now, using a formulated electrolyte supplement within your training and or your daily routine, it will eliminate some of the challenges we all have faced and still facing. I know for a fact that did help me quite a bit for the past few months, and I continue to take a specific formula that has no added carbohydrates or anything else. Some of the audience I tend to coach, they break the capsule and they input that powder into a 1 liter water container. And some they consume it twice a day, once in the morning and once in the evening. So it is something you should definitely look into, and it's what you prefer. In addition, for some of the audience that practice a carb loading once a week for muscle growth, on that specific day, you will tend to actually lose more electrolytes than usual. So that said, having 1 cup of pure coconut water mixed in with your protein shake and or other supplements right after your training will assist in recovery and will assist in replenishing your bodily fluid a lot faster than just having a regular meal, for example. Again, I just want to say thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and turn notification on for future episodes. So just to kind of recap very quickly here are the list of electrolytes. You got calcium, magnesium, potassium, sodium, and chloride. Also, the current formula that I am currently testing right now, I will go ahead and actually list the milligrams of what's in per capsule. So therefore, when you actually go out and you are purchasing your own electrolyte supplements, you can actually compare the milligram dosages between yours and the current one that I'm testing. Also, the way I actually take my electrolytes, usually I take one in the morning, 30 minutes after my coffee, and in the evening after my training. And I tend to adjust accordingly every 10 days whether I require more and or less. My first symptom, yes, was cramping, which I made a huge mistake by actually ignoring that symptom for so long, that recently I start to experience quite a bit of a regular heartbeat. And for me, that was a bit scary because it was preventing me from resting. It was preventing me from recovering from a workout. And it felt to a point where you're experiencing something abnormal. And as soon as I start taking the electrolytes twice a day, within about 3 days, I was fully balanced. The regular heartbeat was gone. And of course, no more cramping whatsoever, especially on a carb day when I push myself and I end up doing a carb loading. It's all about being educated on certain things that are happening and be tuned with your body. So the moment you notice something is abnormal, something is off, try to research it, try to kind of question it, why this is happening. Because if you know for a fact you are on a healthy eating diet, you are eating quite clean, you know, proper protein and proper fat ratios, and if you're practicing carb loading once a week, you know for a fact, you know exactly the food you are consuming, and if by something minor start to kind of accumulate or happens, start looking after it immediately. Don't delay it.